Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm Ashi Adani and I have been blogging about fashion and beauty for about 3 years now. I really thought it was high time I got up close and personal with you guys. So here's my channel. I'm going to be making a lot of vlogs, travel videos, fashion, beauty and a lot of that content. So let's just get started. For today's video, we will be talking about the My Glamm x Manish Malhotra collection. For those of you who don't know about either, My Glamm is an Indian makeup brand. They have a lot of multitasking makeup products which I have been using for the longest time. And they have collaborated with Manish Malhotra, who is a very big Indian designer, to come up with a range of very glamorous makeup products. I have a few of them here in front of me and we are going to be trying them out today. Also, before we get started, I had to tell you guys that I'm giving away something super special at the end of the video, so you need to stay tuned for that. So first I'm going to take you through what all this collection has to offer and then we will get to trying them out. So this collection has 2 9-in-1 foil eyeshadow palettes, 5 4-in-1 eyeshadow palettes, 12 high shine lipsticks, 6 high shine glosses, 1 highlighter stick, 2 blush sticks, 18 nail lacquers. For today's video, we'll be trying an eyeshadow quartz, a high shine lipstick and a high shine gloss. So let's just open this up. So this is the eyeshadow quartz. The packaging looks quite nice. It looks quite luxurious. And the fan is pretty small. The box is pretty small. Let's see. The pans are also pretty small. So this one has 1 matte shadow, 2 foil shadows and 1 glitter shadow. It also has a nice big mirror, which I appreciate. So I'm gonna get you guys a little closer and we will try to do a look using just these shadows. So I'm going to start by using the matte brown shade in this palette. And you can see there's quite a lot of fallout here. I'm just going to use this one on my crease and it's quite pigmented actually. And I'm just using swiping motions. Also going to get a lot of it on my outer edge because we don't have a darker shade here. So I think this is going to be my smoky eye. So this definitely blends easily. I'm just going to take a clean blending brush and just blend the edges out more. And okay, now I'm just going to take a flat brush like this one here. And I'm just going to take the glitter shade and it's like a little bit of an olive. This just dropped a lot of products. I can't do the clink thing. I directly have to kind of drag this on my eyelid as is. Okay, that's it for this. I'm just going to take another flat brush and I'm going to take the pink foil eyeshadow all over the rest of the lid. I think it'll perform better with, like, this is good pigment, however I think it'll perform better with a finger. I mean, most foil eyeshadows do. Yeah, see, it's definitely better with a finger. Actually, let's take that glitter shade again with a finger. I'm just gonna stamp this one on because it has a lot of fallout. Anyway, we're going to go back in the matte shade, matte brown, and just blend this edge again. So this looks nice, but I'm just going to have to take a brush with powder, with some powder on it, and wipe that away. There's a lot of fallout. Now for the lower lash line, take a small itty bitty brush and I'm just going to drag that brown on my waterline. This brown will look good on most skin tones, that's what I can tell, which is amazing. I'm going to take the foil golden shadow on this inner corner. This will open up your eye for sure. I'm just going to finish up this eye, put on some liner and mascara, and we will be right back. Hi guys, so I'm surprisingly happy with how this look eye look turned out, considering it was just 4 shades. I do like the palette. I think it feels very nice, it looks very nice, and the pigmentation is amazing as well. However, I think 1250 rupees is a lot for the size of the product that you're getting. The pans are really, really small, and there's a lot of fallout. I cannot explain to you guys how much fallout is there. Like, even after doing the look, when I kept the brushes down, my table has pigment on it. It's the fallout is way too much. But other than that, if you can manage that, if you do your eyes before doing your base, I think it's manageable. It's not that big a deal. But I feel like the product is a little too pricey for the amount that you're getting. Moving on, I will go ahead and let's try the high shine gloss. Now this one also packaging is the same. Looks nice, looks like a normal glass gloss tube, and it does not have a doe foot applicator. It has a round and pointed applicator, so it'll be interesting to try that out. Now this one's like a metallic gloss. I'm not really a fan of metallics, that I'm going to tell you from now, but I do know people who love it, so I think I'm just going to give this a fair shot. I have it in the shade Ravishing Red. Not bad. I think it would be better if I went on with a lip liner, but yeah, it's not bad, but it's just a little too heavy and sticky for me. Also, I feel like because it's a very oily gloss, if that makes sense, but it's because it's so oily, it makes me feel like it's going to keep moving around all the time, and I feel like it's really defining my creases. I think that's because of the metallic in it. Yeah, I feel like I need to keep doing that, otherwise the gloss and the metallic keep separating on my lips. So honestly, I don't see myself reaching out for this one very often. This costs 1050 rupees, which is a lot. I am not a fan of the applicator because I had to keep going in over and over again because this does not pick up a lot of product. I would, however, wear this if it was like a conceptual shoot or something like that, definitely. But I just don't see myself wearing this for a special event. Maybe with some lipstick underneath, but definitely not wearing this for a special event because I just don't feel like it will stay on the lips, you know, throughout the event. Especially if I eat or something, though, I don't think this stands a chance. So this one's kind of a no-go for me, but if you are someone who enjoys metallic glosses, maybe you can give this one a shot. So I got the metallic gloss off my lips. However, there's still glitter in the creases of my lips. I don't know what I'm going to do of that. Anyway, moving on to the high shine lipstick. Now this one is for 950 rupees. I really like the packaging. It has a magnetic packaging. It looks very rich and luxurious, and the shade I have is called Barely Nude. It's a nice pink nude for an everyday. So it's on, it's nice, it's opaque. I really like the shade. I think it will look good on a lot of skin tones. This is very, very creamy. Like, it's extremely creamy. Like, you can't feel it on your lips. It's very light and it's very creamy, which I enjoy. I genuinely do. I have stopped wearing lipsticks for a very long time now. All I wear is liquid lipsticks, but I guess I would make an exception with this one because it's so comfortable to wear. I know my mom's gonna like this shade and the feel and the comfort of this. So if you really like this shade, and they have a lot of shades in this range, I think the formula is amazing. It's quite opaque. You can't see the darkness around the lips or anything like that. So this one's a pass for me. I really like this one. So yeah, that's it for my review, you guys. Moving on to the giveaway, I'm going to be giving away an eyeshadow quartz, a high shine lip gloss and a high shine lipstick plus a nail lacquer. All you need to do is subscribe to my channel, follow me on Instagram and comment your Insta handle down below and let me know which product you'd like to try the most. Also, check out the description box for more details about these products, my social media handles, and I hope to see you guys in my next video. Bye!